In terms of prioritization, Abby, in your own experience, what are the drivers for that prioritization? How do you know what the priorities should be? Are they because they align most with your tasking, or is it something else that's helping you understand what is the priority that I should be going after?
Yeah, I think prioritization can be your mission critical items that you are supposed to focus on, your collection requirements as an analyst. You want to prioritize based on those. If you have an area of responsibility, a region that you're focusing on, you don't care about every single bit of online data and social media information that's happening in that space. You care about specifically the mission critical activities and communications to you. So for example, if I'm looking to track new weapons development taking place by Iranian or Iranian offshoot groups, then I don't care about every time somebody talks about anything in that region. I care about when they mention the development of those weapon types, when they're mentioning facilities where those weapon types might be built. I want to focus on those subsets. So priorities for me are going to be communications that fall into my collection requirement. The second priority for me is ensuring I'm adequately answering those first two challenges, access and storage. My second priority is making sure that when I'm looking at this, have they jumped to communicate somewhere else? Is the real conversation happening somewhere else? Is there a gap in my intelligence? Which is, again, like you said, a tradecraft question as old as time. I know what I have, but I can't assume that everything I have is what's going on in the space. Where's my gap? Is the conversation happening somewhere else? And for OSINT, a lot of the times that means the movement to a new platform like we were discussing earlier. So identifying that movement, identifying maybe indicators of those internal motivators that we were talking about earlier so that I can maybe preempt the move even and just follow them as they go. So those are my two priorities as I see them.
Very good. And Sean, that sounded to me like a very similar thought process to the way that intelligence has always been prioritized. Mission critical, and then indicators and warnings that help you understand where to go next in your intelligence collection. Does that resonate with you? Is that how you see it, what you've heard from Abby?
Yeah, and I would take it up as a higher level. You know, it's really good to hear Abby is clearly a brilliant analyst. But for me, at the more senior level, you've got to set the right demand signal. You've got to really, you know, get that into the detail of what it is that you want to know and why you want to know it. So we used to, when I was an analyst, we used to say there's no such thing as stupid answers, just stupid questions. And there was some truth to that, because it was like, well, tell me what you know. Well, in order to what? Because there is so much data out there and so much information that unless you really drill down into this is what we need to know and this is why we need to know it, that you've got no hope of actually being able to do the sort of triage and then the management, et cetera, that Abby's been talking about, unless you've got a really good idea. And that requires, you know, a lot of skills between the analyst and the senior commander, but it requires an intelligent senior commander to really understand how to use the capability better. So for me, it's all about setting that requirement in the right way.